Many of his niti are still relevant to our time, but many of his niti does not imply that it's righteous from moral ground and living perspective, but it will definitely help you all to understand the people mindset and how the powerful man had implied such discriminating teaching as lifeless.
Chanakya Niti, Chapter 16. The heart of a woman is not united, it is divided. While she is talking with one man, she looks lustfully at another and thinks fondly of a third in her heart. The fool who fancies that a charming young lady loves him becomes her slave, and he dances like a bird tied to a string. Who is there who, having become rich, has not become proud? Which man in this world has not been overcome by a woman? Who is always loved by a king? Who is there who has not been overcome by a ravage of time? Which beggar has attained glory? Who has become happy by contracting the vice of the wicked? A man attains greatness by his merits, not simply by occupying an exalted seat. Can we call a crow an eagle simply because the crow sits on the top of a tall building? The man who is praised by others as great is regarded as worthy, though he may be really void of all merit. But the man who sings his own praises lowers himself in the estimation of others, though he should be God Indra. I do not deserve that wealth which is to be attained by enduring much suffering, or by transgressing the rules of virtue, or by flattering an enemy. Those who were not satisfied with the enjoyment of wealth, food, and woman have all passed away. There are others now passing away who are not satisfied. And in the future, still others will pass away, feeling themselves not satisfied. All charities and sacrifices bring only temporary result, but gifts made to deserving person and protection offered to all creatures shall never perish. A blade of a grass is light. Cotton is lighter. The beggar is infinitely lighter. Still, why then does not the wind carry him away? Because the wind fears that the beggar may ask alms of him as well. It is better to die than to preserve this life by incurring disgrace. The loss of life causes but a moment's grief, but disgrace brings grief every day of one's life. All the creatures are pleased by loving words, and therefore we should address words that are pleasing to all, and there is no lack of sweet words. There are two nectarian fruits hanging from the tree of this world. One is the hearing of sweet words, and other is the society of saintly men. The good habits of charity, learning, and austerity practiced during many past lives continue to be cultivated in this birth by virtue of the link of this present life to the previous ones. One whose knowledge is confined to books, and whose wealth is in the possession of others, can use neither his knowledge nor wealth when the need for the time arises.